Patrolling the familiar aisles of the shopping center, Officer Daniel stumbled upon a sight that tugged at his heartstrings. Tucked away in a forgotten corner of the parking lot, a tiny figure, barely 3 years old, sat alone, dwarfed by the surrounding vehicles. Apprehension washed over him as he approached cautiously, lowering himself to her level. Tears glistening in her eyes, the little girl looked up at Officer Daniels and whispered something that sent shivers down his spine. Before we embark on this captivating journey, we kindly invite you to show your support by engaging with our content. Please consider giving this video a thumbs up, subscribing to our channel, and leaving a thoughtful comment stating, "I've subscribed." Additionally, if you find this story as inspiring as we do, don't forget to share it with your loved ones. Your support means the world to us. The officer's concern deepened. Ella's whispered words,
"Mom doesn't want me home,"
hung heavy in the air. He strove to balance gentleness with the rising worry that gnawed at him. Could she be truly alone? He dismissed the thought, clinging to the belief that her parents were simply lost themselves.
"Let's go inside, okay?"
He offered his hand, and they entered the bustling mall together. Reaching the control room, he relayed the situation to the information officer. An announcement echoed through the building, calling for Ella's parents to come forward. A flicker of hope flickered in the officer's eyes, but it was quickly extinguished by the sight of Ella's face crumpling in despair.
"No, Mommy doesn't want me,"
she repeated, her voice barely a whisper. A silent exchange filled the room, a shared uncertainty between the officer and the information officer. They decided to wait, the announcement echoing once more. Yet, the corridors remained empty, the security cameras revealing nothing but deserted pathways. As the shopping center's closing time loomed, the weight of the situation settled upon them, heavy and ominous. A glimmer of hope emerged. Jason skillfully diverted Ella's attention, transforming their walk to the station into a vibrant counting game, identifying every yellow car they encountered. Upon arrival, Michelle, a colleague with a daughter, seemed like the perfect fit to provide Ella with a sense of comfort. The mention of plush toys in Michelle's office sparked genuine delight in Ella, allowing Jason to focus entirely on finding her parents. Despite scouring databases and missing person reports, Jason found no leads. He needed to delve deeper, sifting through the sparse clues he possessed. Re-examining the surveillance footage, he expanded his search, meticulously scrutinizing every frame for even the faintest sign of interaction with Ella. Driven by her cryptic words, Jason embarked on a mission to unearth the elusive house with blue doors. He ventured into the town's forgotten corners, his eyes scanning relentlessly for that unique shade of blue. The undertaking felt akin to searching for a needle in a haystack, yet the yearning to unravel Ella's story propelled him forward, urging him deeper into the labyrinthine, neglected streets of the town's forgotten sector. His relentless pursuit bore fruit. There it stood, the house with blue doors, exactly as Ella had described. But the image he encountered shattered the vision of a warm, welcoming haven. The house stood desolate, windows boarded, its garden choked by weeds. A thick silence, heavy with abandonment, clung to it like a shroud. Stepping inside, Jason was met by a deafening quiet, the echo of a life once lived resonating within the hollow walls. Each room held a tale of neglect, peeling paint and dust-laden surfaces painting a vivid picture of the vibrant life that had once filled these now eerily silent spaces. The evidence pointed to a hasty departure, a sudden exit hinting at a story steeped in urgency and, perhaps, desperation. Each room served as a fragmented chapter in Ella's life before the parking lot. The once vibrant walls, now faded and peeled, must have echoed with the sounds of laughter and joy. Dust-laden toys and small clothes lay scattered, silent testaments to the child who once played, cherished, and called this place home. The house's disrepair mirrored the turmoil that had likely engulfed Ella's family. Broken furniture, cracked picture frames, and the overall dilapidation spoke volumes of decline and distress. Ella's plight stirred a complex cocktail of emotions within Jason. A powerful sense of connection and responsibility settled upon him, unlike anything he'd experienced in his career. Her vulnerability and resilience resonated deeply, fueling his unwavering determination to reunite her with her family. Whispers of the parents' abrupt departure left Jason with a growing list of unanswered questions. What had triggered such a drastic move? Were the financial and social woes mentioned by the neighbors just a glimpse of a more profound story? These shadowy fragments of the past complicated the situation further, adding a layer of heartbreaking complexity. Amidst his investigation, Jason stumbled upon a serendipitous discovery, a hidden room concealed behind a movable bookcase. Unlike the rest of the house, this hidden space appeared untouched by time, a stark contrast to the general decay. Stepping inside, a wave of intrigue and apprehension washed over him. He sensed that this room might hold crucial pieces to the puzzle, unlocking secrets of Ella's family history. Jason's next move took him to the dusty mailbox outside the abandoned house. He meticulously sifted through each piece of mail, diligently noting down the senders. Amongst the usual bills and unsolicited brochures, he searched for any shred of correspondence that could offer a glimmer of hope, a clue to unravel the mystery of the family's disappearance and Ella's current situation. Among the assorted mail, one specific set caught Jason's eye: several letters from a local women's shelter. This discovery piqued his curiosity, offering a tangible link to a support network for vulnerable women and children. The shelter's involvement hinted at a deeper struggle within Ella's family, a hidden reality masked by the facade of their abandoned home. The letters themselves proved to be a heartbreaking revelation. They were a mix of official documents and personal pleas for assistance, painting a stark picture of Ella's mother's desperation. They confirmed that she had been in contact with the shelter, desperately seeking guidance and support. She wrote of her failing health, highlighting her inability to care for Ella alone. Each line carried the weight of urgency and fear, a mother's desperate plea to protect her child. Through the shelter staff, Jason pieced together the tragic puzzle. Faced with a deteriorating health condition and dwindling options, Ella's mother made the agonizing decision to leave her daughter at the shopping center. In a desperate act of love, she hoped someone would find Ella and provide a better future, a future she was no longer able to offer herself. This final resort, born out of desperation and love, painted a portrait of a mother pushed beyond her limits. Further inquiries revealed another layer of complexity. The shelter staff had limited information about Ella's father, but what they knew was far from comforting. They believed he was involved in illegal activities and had vanished without a trace. This revelation shed light on why Ella's mother might have felt so profoundly alone in her struggles, adding another dimension to the heartbreaking reality of their situation. The stark reality of Ella's abandonment settled upon Jason like a shroud. Alone in the world, first by her mother's tragic demise and then by her father's disappearance, Ella's journey was a testament to profound loneliness and vulnerability. The weight of this realization pressed heavily on Jason, forging an unshakable commitment to ensuring a better, safer future for Ella. Years later, as Ella's laughter filled their home, Jason, now her official godfather, would often reminisce on their journey. He marveled at the profound impact she had on his life, transforming him in ways he never imagined. Their story, he realized, was not just about Ella finding a home, but also about him finding a purpose. It was a testament to the unexpected twists of life, the unwavering power of compassion, and the transformative beauty of caring for another human being. In finding Ella, Jason had not only helped a lost child, but had, in turn, discovered a deeper sense of connection and belonging that had forever changed him. Their bond, forged through shared hardship and unwavering love, became a beacon of hope, illuminating a path towards a brighter future for both of them.